When I think I need someone, they wrap their arms around my old bones. And I start breaking apart.
Wasting time watching the world pass us by.
Hey, it's Jay Gray. Welcome back to Wing It Wednesday. This week I am doing 13 Underappreciated Bands, Part 2. If you've been here for a while, you would know that I did a part one of this in 2016, I would guess. That was probably when it was. Maybe even 2015. Damn. Anyway, so I'm doing a part two of this, 13 new bands, not new bands, but 13 bands that are different to the bands that I had in my original 13 bands. These, I think, are also underappreciated. So, here we go. 13 more... I don't know why I went like this. 13 more bands that are totally underappreciated. Some of which, still, yes, may be popular, but that's not the point of this video. These are in no particular order, so... don't think I'm favoriting or, you know, anything like that. Not picking favorites. I don't have any favorites out of these. I do have favorites out of these, but they're not in any order, so let's go. Forever, but you let them too high, forced away inside. Now they want us to surrender. Now the first band I want to talk about today is Small Pools. They're sort of indie pop, I guess. The first song I heard from them was Dreaming. That was a free song on iTunes at one point, so I got that, and that's how I found out about this band. My favorite song by them is probably Million Bucks or Dreaming. It's one of the two. I mean, Dreaming is the first song I heard from them, so I mean, it has a lot of stuff behind it, but like, Million Bucks is pretty good too. I'm sure they have other good songs, but yeah, those two are. Yep. Number two, Real Friends. Now, I know this band is pretty popular in certain scenes, but I still don't think that they get the appreciation they deserve. I mean, okay, they're sort of pop-punk, emo, sort of more pop-punk, but there's a little bit of emo in there. The first song I heard from them was I Had a Heart, which was on the Punk Goes Christmas album by Fearless Records. My favorite song from them, I do have several, but my favorite is probably 16. That's if I don't say I Had a Heart. The only reason I Had a Heart isn't my favorite song by Real Friends is because it's a Christmas song. If it wasn't directly Christmassy and it didn't mention Christmas at all, that would probably be my favorite song by them. Number three, Man Overboard. These guys are adorable, honestly. They're pop punk. First song I heard from them was How to Hide Your Feelings, because it came on a free album, which was promoting like breast cancer safety or awareness or something like that. Anyway, found that on a free album, and then I was like, oh yeah, let's check these guys out. Favorite song by them? I don't know, Where I Left You, maybe? I don't know, I have a couple again, tied, sort of. I don't really have favorites. I have, most bands I will have, like, two or three favorite songs by them. So, yeah. Favorites are hard. Number four. Get Scared. Post-hardcore. Favorite song? No, sorry, not favorite song. First song I heard from them was Sarcasm. My favorite song by them is also Sarcasm, but I also like Deepest Cut and Whore. All three of those were basically the first songs I heard from them because I heard of them and then I looked them up and I listened to Sarcasm and then I listened to the other to, I don't remember what order though, but they were all listened to on the same day, and then whenever I was listening to Get Scared, I would listen to all three of them, so they're all sort of bunched in together, but overall, Sarcasm's probably my favourite, and I'm not sure if that's because of the sass, or because it has another one of my favourite singers featured in it. I don't know. They also did a really good cover of My Own Worst Enemy by Lit. That was on the Punk Goes 90s Volume 2 compilation by Fearless Records. So go check that out as well, because that was a pretty damn good cover. High five for number 5. This is Royal Blood. They're not actually a band, technically. They're a duo. Psychedelic rock, I guess, kind of, yeah. Favorite song by them is Out of the Black, which is also the first song I heard from them. Again, that was a free song on iTunes at a point in time. Another song that I do like by them, though, is Lights Out. Smoke another cigarette, it kills the pain, that's all that's left of me anymore. Number 6 is Dead by Sunrise. Now this was a super group. The singer in this was Chester Bennington, who you may know from Linkin Park. They were sort of alt-rock slash post-grunge, apparently. I would say they were alt-rock. First song I heard from them was Let Down. Favourite song by them is Too Late. Is it the way we are? Number 7. Electric Century. Another duo. They're electropop. First song I heard from them was You Got It All Wrong. First song I heard from them. Because I got the album free with an issue of Kerrang. So that's the first song on the album, therefore it's the first song I heard. Favorite song by them is Let You Get Away, but I'm also tired with I Lied, because I love both of those. I love the whole album. It's a beautiful album, beautifully done. But Let You Get Away and I Lied are probably tied for my favorite song. Who would Jesus kill? The double talk is past so real. Now this one may actually be kind of popular in some areas. Wouldn't shock me. They are brilliant. But of the people that I actually talk to, none of them seem to know who this band is. So I think that they need a lot more appreciation. And this band is Anti-Flag. I love this band because they just comment on like real shit. They comment on real shit and they talk about it and just openly and just sort of blast out their thoughts. And I know there are a lot of bands that do that, but I like the way Anti-Flag does it. They've called out Trump and Trump supporters as well, so good on ya. Anyway, they're sort of punk rock, anarcho-punk, hardcore punk. They're punk. First song I heard from them was Welcome to 1984, which is actually an acoustic song, and I heard it on a Punk Goes Acoustic album. I believe it was Punk Goes Acoustic Volume 2. Again, another compilation by Fearless Records. My favorite song by them is Racists. Come on, it's so catchy. It's so catchy and so true, and I love it. Number 9. Now talking about bands that like talking about politics and shit. Chumbawamba. Again, another band that a lot of people have either heard of or at least will recognize the song by. They were alt-rock, experimental, a bit of anarcho-punk. Now, the first song I heard from them would have been Tub Thumping. Maybe Farewell to the Crown, but I would say Tub Thumping would have been the first song I heard from them. And even if you don't have a clue what any of what I've just said was, if you don't know what Chumbawamba is or you don't know what Tub Thumping is, I'm sure if you listen to the song you'll be like, oh, it's that, and you'll totally get it then. Favorite song by them is Mouthful of Shit. Listen to it. Trust me. You will not regret it. I'm begging, darling, can we do it again? 'Cause you came in love, my three best friends. Number 10, Eva Explosion. Now, in my last 13 underappreciated bands video, I actually talked about Jamison Parker, which was a duo composed of Jamison Covington and Parker. I don't remember if it was Case or Chase. I feel so bad for not remembering that right now. Anyway, I don't remember what Parker went off to do. I think he went and joined another band. But Jamison went and he started E for Explosion, which, to carry on from Jamison Parker, obviously is emo, but they were also sort of alt rock, sort of indie. The first song I heard from them was I Explode, and my favorite song by them, though I have a few that are technically tied, is Polaroids. I wanna be lost in you, like a ship. Number 11. Do I go like this? Do I go like this? Do I go like this? I don't know. Something, I don't know. Somewhere in there. There's an 11. Thousand Foot Crutch. They're an alt rock band, but they're also a Christian rock band. Now, don't let that put you off. Yeah. Christian rock. Sounds a bit iffy. Sounds a bit, stay away from that. But actually, no. They're pretty good. They are pretty good. The first song I heard from them was Take It Out On Me. Favorite song by them is Be Somebody. And again, don't let the Christian side of things put you off, because they are still a good band if you just ignore that. Number 12, Harvey Danger. Now, this band I do think is definitely underappreciated. A lot of people will know of Flagpole Sitter. That was the first song I heard from them. They're an alt-rock band, by the way. My favourite song by them is still Flagpole Sitter, but that is not to say that they don't have heaps of other good songs. They do have quite a few songs that are pretty good. So I think you should definitely go and check those out. If you like Flagpole Sitter, look, their other songs aren't totally like that, but they have a sort of variety of a sound, but his voice is quite unique. I like his voice. You know what? That's all I can really say about them. But they are underappreciated, and you should go listen to them, because Flagpole Sitter is not their only good song, and more people need to remember that Harvey Danger was a band. They were a thing. And yeah. Number 13, and this is the last band on this list, Aiden. A lot of people probably have heard of this band. They are amazing. They had quite a few albums. I think they had like 6 albums, and at one point they actually released all of them for free. So, way to go, buds! Horror punk, if you're into that. Actually, the only band I've actually heard of being horror punk. But they are freaking amazing. The first song I heard from them would have been Cry Little Sister, which was a cover of a song by Gerard McMahon, who released it under the name Gerard McMahon. The first song I heard from them that wasn't a cover was probably Die Romantic. And my favorite song by them, now this was a really hard one to pick, because Aiden is actually one of my favorite bands. I love quite a few of their songs, so it did take a lot for me to choose one, but I'm going with Hysteria, and I'm going to say that it's sort of tied with Sins of a Father. I do love both of those songs. But Hysteria is probably my favorite, honestly, let's be real. I had to narrow this down from like 7, so yeah. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching this. Feel free to let me know what you think. Do you agree with any of these bands? Do you disagree with any of these bands? Do you think some of them are good, some of them are shit, some of them need more attention, less attention? What's going on? Do you have any bands that aren't included in this list or the last one that do need more attention that I have not mentioned, let me know in the comments down below. If there's anything you want to see in the future, let me know. Don't forget to go and vote for Wing It Wednesday next week. I don't know why I just looked around like I was trying to point to where that was. I don't know. But don't forget to go and vote for it either way. And I will see you guys next week. Stay awesome.